Welcome back to the channel. I appreciate you guys for stopping in. We're on Vinland Saga Season 1, Episode 8, and I'm curious if we're going to get that duel. The title is Beyond the Sea, so I'm not really sure if we're going to get it right away or if he's going to kind of delay a little bit longer, because I feel like Thorfinn kills this man. But only one way to find out. Let's dive in. Let's see what happens.
Oi! 軍船が来た!
待てよ! よく見ろ! アシラったそんな船だ!
やっとブラか。今年も生き延びたぜ。また死んだこなったな、ビョルン。随分遠出しちまったからな。やろうども。今年もご苦労だった。大いに冬を楽しんでくれたまえ。I feel like my man is trying to avoid that duel. I don't think he wants that smoke if I'm being honest.
すげえお宝だな。フランクの地で大勝利だったとさ。乗るならやっぱアシラットさんの船だぜ。バカ。
They
say that as if, like, he's not been there before, right? Like, if they're coming back after a successful year and he's been with them for years now, you'd assume that he's been to this village multiple times.
Yo,
My man's out here pimping. Okay.
ここの女たちは慎み手もんがなくて実にいいな。女より真面目な話じゃ。お前の手下の一日の食い物代が銀貨一枚と四分の一だ。今年は豚が値上がりした。ビールは別料金で、それに宿代と薪代を加えて。おじき、心配するな。手下どもには酒も餌も十分にやってくれ。
金は払うよ。それが聞きたかったんじゃよ。金はいい。見てるだけで気持ちが明るうなる。<笑>うん。I can feel that。これ、ホルザランド。何しとる?早うワインを持ってこんか。変なのだな。あの奴隷女。ホルザランド。ん?ノルウェーの土地の名だ。漁師の血筋らしいが戦に負けて、お家が滅んだとか。
お嬢様育ちは気ぐらいばかり高くて役に立たん。立ち会いに頼んでもいいかな。晩飯前に決闘の予約が入っててさ。役に立たないのは奴隷のせいじゃないぜ。あんたの使い方が下手なんだよ。どんな奴にでも上手に使うコツってのがあるもんさ。頑張れ、小僧。やったり。負けんなよ。It's about to get real. So, again, I feel like there's three possible outcomes, and I'm probably going to be wrong on every single one of them. Either Askeladd beats him, and I don't, is it Askeladd or Askeladd? Askeladd. I'm going to have to listen to when they say his name, but either way, let's just Askeladd. If he beats him, I feel like he's going to have to just like power himself up. You know what I'm saying? Like he's going to have to level up a little bit more before he can get that fight again. Or he beats Askeladd. Now I forget what my thoughts were. I said it in the last episode, but it's been a little bit of time between that episode and this episode. I want to say he either beats Askeladd and kills him. It depends on if it's a duel to the death, or he doesn't kill him. But either way, maybe he takes over his men, which it doesn't seem very likely. If anything, Askeladd might still beat him. And then it becomes a process of him maybe having to leave or something, but he levels up and then comes back to get him. Or he beats him, and then his next step is Floki, because he finds out that that's the person that put into motion his father being killed. It's the only thing that I could think, right? I feel like there could possibly be some other outcomes, but I guess it depends on if it's a fight to the death or not.
Odin の名において、トルフィン対アシラッドの決闘を執り行う。武器は各々好きに選んでよい。なお決闘の理由は、
トルフィンによる彼の父親の敵討ちである。では始め。トルフィンも懲りねえな。年何本になった。あん時はまだお前こんくらいの。おっと、懐に入ったぞ。年寄りの世間話ぐらい。付き合えよ。
トナギであんなに吹っ飛ばした。バカ言え、トルフィンが飛んだんだ。くっつけば探検の方が有利なの分かってる。
I assume he hesitated because he was scared to be grabbed, given that he's a bigger guy than him. But I feel like even if he grabbed that one arm, you could have, you know what I'm saying, with the other arm, brought that knife up and caught him, or even got him. I guess maybe you don't want to get him while he's getting his sword because there's no honor in that. But I don't know. This is interesting. This is interesting. He's trying to get him to fight emotionally.
どうですか?俺いっぱい殺してるからさ。思い出せないんだよ。君の父上のこと。俺どうやって殺したっけ?ひょっとしてお前の勘違いってことはないかね?正々堂々戦えば父上は貴様なんかに負けなかった。俺を人質に!ガキの命と引き換えに剣を捨てたあのバカだ!
That's what he wanted. He's physically strong, but he's not mentally there yet. I was hoping he was going to catch him with a knife throw. I was waiting, but I feel like that's not how he wants to win. But I would take it.
あ、負けると意地切る。例のやつか。あそこが落ち着くんだろ。もともとはあいつの親父の船だからな。今日の決闘感動したっす。だけど大将、あんなガキ船に乗せてやばくないっすか。猫身を襲われでもしたら。奴は一応選手だからね。正々堂々一騎打ちで勝たないと嫌なのさ。過去とプライドが奴を縛ってるわけだ。みんなの邪魔だ。さっさと片付けろ。いつまで貴族のつもりでおるんじゃお前は。立て立たんか。金の奴隷が鞭持って金で買った奴隷に囚人面してやがんの。自覚がないだけなのさ。人間はみんな何かの奴隷だ。<笑>
いじけてるな。父上。やーい、泣き虫、刑務士。仕返ししたいか。俺の子だからな。仕返しすんなって言っても無駄だろうし、自分の力で気づくしかないのかもな。お前には敵などいない。誰にも
敵などいないんだ。本当の戦士には剣など。ゴルム様があなたに食事を持ってけって。ねえ、君も奴隷なの？
あ、俺は戦士だ。あんたと違って飯を食う場所を自由に選べる。でもなんだか君、私と同じって感じがするから。奴隷の気持ちなんざ知るか。
俺があんただったらゴルムを殺して逃げる。そんな、殺すなんて。なら一生奴隷でいればいい。あんたの勝手だ。逃げて、どこまでも逃げて、海の彼方まで逃げ切ったら、そこには何があるのかしら。どこまで行ってもここと同じ、戦と奴隷商人がいるだけ。遥か西、海の向こうに、
Vinland という名の土地がある。奴隷商人も戦の炎も届かない。遠い地、そこなら誰も追っては来れない。
I'm gonna be honest with you. The more that they talk about this, the more that I think that Vinland doesn't actually exist. It's more so just a frame of mind, or like it's like a dream place, right? Like it's heaven to them, a place where war doesn't exist, slavery doesn't exist, none of this stuff happens. And in all reality, if humans live there, all of this happens. I'd find it hard to believe that it doesn't, but it seems like it might be a tale that they tell kids, and then kids grow up, and then they tell, you know what I mean? I could be wrong. Maybe we find out that I'm wrong, but that's what it feels like. This is a year later.
Denmark各地より各部族の精鋭たち集結しつつあります。 加えて我ら用務戦士団4個大隊、馳せ参じております。
ようやくだ。
イングランドの不尊な輩どもに王の力を示さねばならぬ。してクヌーとはあやつは来ておるな。
はっ。殿下もすでにイエリングに入られ、
やはりお考えは変わらぬのでしょうか。
ラグナル殿、
兄のハラルドに劣らぬ武勲の機会を与えねばな。
しかし恐れながら殿下はまだ戦場でのご経験も浅く。
よとてクヌートの身は案じておる。だが我らはバイキングの朝明朝出航する。
西暦1013年8月、スヴェン大王率いるデンマークバイキング主力艦隊はイングランド北部のハンバー川より進攻を開始。各地を蹂躙しつつ進軍を続けた。このまま続くと思われた快進撃もここに来て一時停滞することとなる。商業都市ロンドンにて。
どうした、もっと攻めてこいよ。楽しい戦じゃねえか。
A lot of interesting stuff going on. I do feel like Floki is eventually going to be a target for Thorfinn because of the fact that he was really what's behind his father dying. I don't know. It's just, this is a lot of interesting stuff, because if he goes against Floki and he's still a part of the Jomsvikings, I think it was called, then he's going to become a target. So I'm guessing once all of this kind of ensues and happens, then he's going to set out and look for Vinland. That would be my guess. So only one way to find out. Appreciate you guys for stopping in. We'll catch you in the next episode, homies. I blow that flower like Mario. I keep that fire in my hand. Smoking so much, it's like all I show. I don't think they understand. I blow that flower like Mario. I keep that fire in my hand. I just be rolling, that's all I know. I don't think they understand. I just be rocking the boat. Got me a bop in a hole. I'm locked in the coast. I got me a shot and I know. So everything I drop is cold. I be like, who wanna blow on an L? We hit the hotel. A couple of bitches, a little Ciroc. Got one of my niggas. We feeling the vibe. It's comfortable. Pimpin'.